Yeah, students, we have already seen that whenever you are connecting, you are taking a wire and you are connecting it to battery along with a tap key. And if you switch on this, it is positive and this is negative terminal of the battery. Current flow through this circuit, I, and there is some work done by the battery. Work done is equal to V into Q, where V is potential difference of the circuit. In between any two points, whatever, like if you are considering these two points, A and B, potential difference between A and B, VAB, and charge transferred from A to B, if you multiply them, you will be getting work done. So work done W is equal to delta V, where usually delta V is the potential difference offered by the battery. So delta V into Q, where Q is the charge transferred in the circuit. So work done W is delta V into Q. And as we know, whenever there is some work done, definitely there should be some form of energy stored or some form of energy consumed, right? Therefore, capacity of doing work. Capacity of doing work is energy, right? Who is doing work here? Battery is doing work. Battery is bringing, like battery is doing some work in such a way, like it is transferring the charge from one part of the circuit to the other part. It is transferring electrical energy, it means. So therefore, capacity of doing work is known as energy, and that is electrical energy, which we are going to define here, electrical energy. So the electrical energy consumed, the electrical energy consumed in a circuit is defined as work done in maintaining the current in the electric circuit for a given amount of time. So simply, it is electrical energy is equal to work done by the battery. Work done by the battery is equal to VQ. V is equal to IR into Q. This can be written as I square R into T. Right? Or even we can write E is equal to W, which is equal to Q into V, where you can write it as IT, where V is potential difference, I is current in the circuit. So therefore, E can be written as VIT. So that is electrical energy. So it is defined as the amount of work done by the battery in maintaining current in the circuit for a given instant of time. So for a given time, how much amount of current is maintained in the circuit? That is said to be as electrical energy. And now coming to electric power. As we know, what is definition of power? Power is equal to work done by time taken. Or you can write it as average power is delta W divided by delta T. And what is this work done? Work done can be equal to energy. So simply you can write energy divided by time gives you power. Therefore, how much amount of electrical energy or how much amount of electric work is being done per unit time, it is defined as electric power. Therefore, electric power is equal to electric work done divided by time taken, that is delta W divided by delta T. And let us now write down unit of these two. So electrical energy has unit joule, because unit of energy is however joule. But practically, when we are dealing with electrical energy, the commercial unit which we use is kilo watt hour, which is usually called as one unit. So when we are dealing with electric bill, electricity bill in our home, generally we will be talking about the number of units consumed by all the components in the home. So we have a fridge and TV, some different electrical consumers we have. based on our utility, there will be monthly bill. And in that monthly bill, you can, it is being displayed, these many units has been consumed. Some consume 100 units, some, if there are more components, then you will be getting like 300, 400 units can be consumed. So what that one unit mean? One unit is 1 kilowatt hour. And remember, kilowatt hour is the unit of energy. It is not unit of power. Most of you may be misguided. What, as there is watt here, most of you consider that it is unit of power, but that is wrong. It is kilowatt hour, unit of energy. Kilowatt hour is unit of energy. Now let me write what is mean by 1 kilowatt hour. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to, how do you write kilo? Kilo is 10 power 3. And how do you write watt? Watt can be written as joule per second. Into 1 hour is 60 into 60. 1 hour is 60 minute, and 60 minute, 1 minute is 60 second. That is what I am writing here. This is equal to 36 into 10 power 5 joule. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 36 into 10 power 5 joule. Usually our, the minimum electrical consumption for one house is approximately 100 units. 100 units mean 100 into 36 into 10 power 5 joule. Remember, 10 power 5 joule, you are consuming lot of energy. So this is the commercial unit of energy. 1 kilowatt hour is written as 36 into 10 power 5 joule. And coming to the power, unit of power, unit of work done is joule. And unit of time is second. Joule per second is simply called watt. Joule per second is 1 watt. And 1 watt is 1 joule per 1 second. 1 joule per second. And the greater units of power can be horsepower, megapower, horsepower, megawatt, gigawatt. These all are generally commercial units of power. Mega, mega is 10 power 6. Megawatt is equal to 10 power 6 watt. Gigawatt is equal to 10 power 9 watt. And 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt. Generally, when we deal with power of motors, electric motors, then in such cases, we will be dealing with horsepower. 5 kHP, 4 kHP motor. Generally, farmers will be using these motors in order to lift water from the well. So you will be using those different types of motors, right? Usually, those motors are being like the commercial unit of that power is being used in order to represent motor power. 5 kHP, 4 kHP, kilo horsepower. 1 horsepower is 746 watt. So that is the way you can define electrical energy and electric power. So let us consider that there are 3 resistors which are connected in series. This is one resistor, this is another resistor, and this is another resistor. All the 3 are connected. These are connected in series, because we are considering it in series connection. So if they are connected in series, you can redraw the circuit like this. This is R. It also has resistance R. This also has resistance R. Now you are connecting these all resistors to a battery along with a tap key. When you switch on the tap key, obviously the potential difference between positive and negative terminal of the battery is being joined with this wire. As a result, some current is developed in the circuit. That current flows through the wire. What is current in the first resistor? I. Current in the second resistor? I. Current in the third resistor is I. What about voltage in the first resistor? V1. Voltage in the second resistor? V2. Voltage in the third resistor? V3. So if I want to find out power in this circuit, P is equal to VIT, where T is time taken. And I can write P is equal to, V can be written as I R into I T. So P is equal to I square into R into T. Sorry. Here T will not be there. I'm extremely sorry. T will not be there in this, because W is equal to V I T. What is power? Power is equal to W by T. That is V I T divided by T. T and T gets cancelled. So that is V I. So P is equal to V I. V, I am just substituting it as I R, because in series combination, current remains same, voltage get divided. As a result, V, I am writing it as I R. I am eliminating V, because I is common for all the three resistors. So I am eliminating V and I am writing it as I R. Therefore, in series combination, you should be habituated to use this formula, P is equal to I square R. So power in the whole circuit will be P equal to I square into equivalent resistance. Equivalent resistance in this case is 3R, because all the three resistors are connected in series combination. Now let us come to second case where resistors are connected in parallel. You have resistors, three resistors are connected in parallel. And these three are connected to a battery. As a result, some current I comes over here, and that current get divided into three parts. One part goes into this, I name it as I1. Another part goes into this, I name it as I2. Another part goes into this, I name it as I3. But what about the voltage? Voltage here will be remained same, because all the three resistors are connected to the same battery. So in parallel combination, what is the result here in the parallel combination? V is equal to constant, I is divided. Therefore, you can simply write power P is equal to VI, where V is voltage and I is current. As I is being divided here, I will be just replacing I is equal to V by R. So P is equal to V into V by R. That is V square by R. Therefore, in parallel combination, you habituate to use this formula, P is equal to V square by R. Therefore, across these all three resistors, same power is being consumed. That is what? V square by R, where V is voltage of all these. Voltage is connected for first resistor V, second one also the same, third one is also the same. And remember, power in case of parallel combination is inversely proportional to resistance R. This is in case of parallel combination. And whereas in series combination, power is directly proportional to square of the current. Right? This is the effective power in case of resistors connected in series and parallel. We will be solving one problem based on electric power. It is being given a 1 kilowatt heater is meant to operate at 200 volt. That is called operating voltage. Operating voltage is 200 volt. You should find out what is its resistance, how much power will it consume if the line voltage drops to 100 volt. How many units of electrical energy will it consume in a month of 30 days if it operates 10 hours daily at the specified voltage? So at the specified voltage, you are supposed to find out how much power is being consumed. Now first, you write down the data what is being given to you. You are being given a 1 kilowatt heater. Power of the heater is being given as 1 kilowatt. This is 1000 watt. And it is meant to operate at 200 volt. So operating voltage is equal to 200 volt. Understand that operating voltage and supplied voltage both cannot be same. So operating voltage. Operating voltage is the voltage which is meant to be operated at that. Generally, our household supply is 220 volt. This is household supply. Generally, all the electrical instruments which is being manufactured in India, they are manufactured in such a way they should be operated at 220 volt only. But in some other countries, in America or if you go to Canada, there the operating voltage is not 220 volt. Operating voltage is slightly less. It can be 180 volt or even it can be 110 volt like this. Operating voltage is less in some cases, or in some cases it can be greater. I don't want to confuse you. Let me take, this is household. What about commercial? Commercially, it is operated at 440 volt. Okay. We have very big machines. Those machines are operated at 440 voltage, which cannot be used by used in our home. So suppose you have very big industry, a large machine we have, that machine should be operated at 440 volt only. You cannot operate it with 220 volt, or you cannot operate it with greater than that 440 volt. So it should be operated at only 440 volt. Sometimes even if less voltage is supplied to that, there will be some defects will be in the machine, but it can be operated even at less than 440 volt. So therefore, operating voltage is the voltage specified on device. It is the voltage specified on the device at that particular voltage only. You need to use that component. And the other voltage is a supplied voltage. Supplied voltage. Remember, supplied voltage is the voltage which you are provided with. The how much voltage you are providing, that voltage is called supplied voltage. Now, let me take one simple example. I'll make it clear with this. You have a bulb. This bulb is to be operated at 220 volt. This is called operating voltage. Bulb is operated at 220 voltage. Its operating voltage is 220 volt. And at 220 volt, its power consumption is 60 watt. What you are doing now, you are taking this bulb and you are connecting it to a battery. And this battery is offering only a value of 110 volt. When you switch on this tap key, operating voltage is 220 volt, but the supplied voltage is only 110 volt. Both are not same. In such cases, the bulb will not glow with greater brightness. The bulb brightness decreases. Right? So that is what the difference between operating voltage and supplied voltage. You need to just pay attention. Which kind of voltage is given in the question. Operating voltage is meant to be operated by that particular device, and supplied voltage or line voltage is the voltage which you are providing to that device. Okay, in this question, operating voltage is 200 volt. That means heater should be used only at 200 volt, but always it may not be the same. In your home, if voltage provided is sometimes fluctuated and you have got half current, in such case, 100 voltage is the voltage which is being supplied. For 100 voltage, even heater works, but it produces less amount of heat energy. Now, come to the question. A 1 kilowatt heater is meant to operate at 200 volt. What is its resistance? You are now supposed to find out the resistance. Resistance of the material does not change. Even though operating voltage, like supplied voltage and operating voltage, both may be differed, but resistance of the material does not change. It remains same. So I will be now finding out resistance of the heater. Resistance of the heater is equal to, we have equation for power, P is equal to V square divided by R. Usually try to habituate the same, use the same equation in order to find out the resistance. P is equal to V square by R. Don't use I square R. Because current is not given to you, voltage and resistance is given, and V is operating voltage given. So whenever you want to find out resistance of the device, you should use operating voltage only, not supplied voltage. In this case, resistance of the heater is equal to V square 1000 whole square divided by power. I'm sorry. Operating voltage is 200. That is 200 into 200 divided by power is 1000. These 2 and 3 zeros gets cancelled. What is left over here? 2 into 20. This is 40 ohm. What is the resistance of the water heater? Resistance of the water heater, it is a 40 ohm. We have calculated the value of heater. It is 40 ohm. Now come to next question. How much power will it consume if the line voltage drops to 100 volt? Actually, its operating voltage is 200 volt. But what is mentioned in the problem? It is being operated at 100 voltage only. You are providing only 100 voltage line supply. Then how much power will it consume if the line voltage is 100 volt? So simply you will be writing here, power P is equal to V square divided by R. What is V? 100 into 100 divided by R. This is 40. 0, 0 gets cancelled. Remained is 4, 2's 8, 4, 5's 20. This is equal to 250 watt. So what happened to power? Power has been decreased to 250 watt. What is actual power consumption? 1 kilowatt, which is operated at 200 volt. But when you are decreasing the voltage, what is the power consumed by the heater? It is just 250 watt is the power consumed by the heater. That is question B. Now come to question number C. How many units of electrical energy will it consume in a month of 30 days if it is operated 10 hours a daily at the specified voltage? So what is the specified voltage? 100 voltage is the specified voltage. At this voltage, how many units of electrical energy is being consumed? So electrical energy E will be equal to V into I into T. Right? Or you can write it as V square divided by R into T is equal to electrical energy. Okay, or you can even write electrical energy is equal to power into time taken. How much is power consumed by the electrical heater at the operating voltage 100? It is 250. That is 250 into how much time it is being operated? 10 hours a day, and this is for 30 days. So it is 30 into 10 hours. And finally, this is answer. Power you are calculating in 250 watt. What should be converted in, what should be written as joule per second? Joule per second, right? So hours also you can convert it into second. So this become into 10 hours. 1 hour is 60 into 60. Okay, this is joule. Answer you will be getting in joule, but you want to find it in units, 1 kilowatt hour. You need to write that. So E will be equal to 25 into 3 into 6 into 6 into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into 10 power 5. Joule should be converted into kilowatt hour. So I will be writing it as 36 into 10 power 5 kilowatt hour. 36 into 10 power 5, 36 into 10 power 5 gets cancelled, which is equal to 25 threes, 75 watt kilowatt hour. So therefore 75 units of electrical energy is being consumed in this case. So when we are connecting three bulbs in series combination, current will be remained same. First one have resistance R1, second one have resistance R2, third one have resistance R3. I am considering that R1 greater than R2 greater than R3. As the resistance in the first bulb is greater, voltage dropped across the first bulb will be greater because V proportional to R. Power consumed at the first bulb will be greater in the first resistor because I am considering R1 is greater than R2 is greater than R3. So remember that across the larger resistor, there will be greater voltage dropped. More voltage is dropped across the greater resistor battery. As a result, it will be having effective brightness. More brightness will be there with greater resistor than that of the less resistor. Now come to parallel combination. We are taking bulbs which are connected in parallel. These three bulbs are connected in parallel with the battery. In such case, current in this is I1, current in this is I2, current in this is I3, resistance here is R1, resistance here is R2, resistance here is R3, power here will be P1, power here will be P2, power here will be P3. In case of parallel combination, how do you write power? P is equal to V square divided by R. Voltage is constant, so P is inversely proportional to R. Similarly, V is equal to IR. Here you can write I is inversely proportional to R. Now, from this data, you can make it clear that power, like greater value resistor, will have less power consumption, and greater value resistor will have more current in the circuit. As a result, voltage is remained same. The one in which greater current passed through, that will be glowing more brightly than that of the others. So understand that carefully. And the one which has less resistance glow more brightly in case of parallel combination. In case of series combination, the one which has more resistance glow brightly in the series. So that is the effective brightness of the bulbs which are connected in series and as well as which are connected in parallel. Now come to this question. See, we have a bulb, 100 watt 220 volt bulb is connected to 110 volt source. Calculate power consumed in the bulb. This is very simple question, but I want to make concept clear. That's the reason why I selected this. See, whatever the voltage is being given, it is 110 watt 220 volt. This is specification of bulb. So what does specification mean? You are taking a bulb upon which there is a specification. It should be used at 220 volt, and this is called operating voltage. It is specified. So on the bulb, it will be specified that you should use the bulb at it that is manufactured such that it is operated at 220 volt. So when you are operating at 220 volt, how much power is consumed? 110 watt is the power consumed when you are operating this at 220 volt. Now what you are doing? You are connecting this bulb to 110 volt source. So you are taking this bulb upon which 220 volt supply, and this is 110 volt. You are connecting it to a voltage of 110 volt. Okay. So I want to now find out what is the power consumed. So if you are operating at 220 volt, power consumed is 110 watt. But when you are operating at 110 volt, what is the power consumed? We have P is equal to V square divided by R. This is number one. But you do not know what is R. As resistance R is not known to you, resistance of the material is equal to V square divided by R. Here V, you need to take it as 220 whole square divided by sorry P and power is 110 watt. R is 220 whole square divided by 100 watt. That I'll substitute here. So power consumed will be V square, that is 110 whole square divided by resistance is 220 whole square into 110 watt. Okay. So finally, this you need to calculate. You will be getting the final answer. Right. So power is given as 100 watt. Just change this. Previously I took 110. It is 100. Substituting those all, you will be getting finally power as 25 watt. 25 watt is the power consumed by the bulb. So two bulbs of 100 watt and 500 watt connected in series, which one glows brighter? I want to find out that. So the one which has greater resistance will glow brighter. That's what we already know. R1 is equal to V square divided by P, it is 100. R2 is equal to 200 whole square divided by 500. Which has greater resistance? Obviously, R1 has greater resistance than R2. R1 is greater than R2. Therefore, 100 watt bulb glow more brighter. Than that of the other. So we have three bulbs being given, B1, B2, B3. 100 watt B1 and 60 watt B2, B3. This is 60 watt. This is 60 watt. This is 100 watt. And all these are connected to a voltage of 250. Now, because of this, there is some current I coming here, and that current divides into two parts, I1 and I2. Okay. Now you should find out W1, W2, W3. W1, W2, W3, where output powers. W1, W2, W3 are output powers. Output powers. So you are supposed to find out the relation between W1, W2, W3. And remember, whatever given here, 100 watt, 60 watt, 60 watt are operating powers. Remember this. These are operating powers. That means when you are operating that bulb at particular specified voltage, operating voltage, it draws a wattage of 100 watt. Okay. So use the concept of bulbs in series and bulbs in parallel. And try to solve this, and you would be getting you need to calculate W1, W2, W3. Okay, so how to find out W1? W1 is first one wattage, so this is one wattage of that will be equal to V square divided by R. So you need to find out how much is voltage dropped across this. Similarly, V square divided by, this is R1, this is R2. It is V square divided by R3. Of course, R1 is different. R2, R3 are same. You can use that. And voltage dropped across these are different, right? So W3 you can calculate easily. W3 is equal to, what is operating voltage of W3? 250. Into 250 divided by, what is its resistance? You need to find out that resistance. R is equal to V square operating voltage. Let us take operating voltage as operating voltage should be mentioned here. Actually, operating voltage is not mentioned in the problem. Operating voltage, you just take it as 300. So operating voltage for all the bulbs, take it as 300. So operating voltage, if you take it 300, then what do you get? R will be equal to V square divided by W. So that will be 300 whole square into W, that is 60. This gives you W3, because W3 directly it is been connected with 250 volt, but this third bulb, its operating voltage is given as 300. I'm substituting that 300. Next, coming to this B1 and B2, first find out R1. R1 is equal to 300 whole square divided by 100. R2 is equal to 300 whole square divided by 60. R1, R2, R3. R3 is equal to 300 whole square divided by 60. These are R1, R2, R3. Just substitute R1, R2, R3 corresponding to the voltages. You will be getting relation between W1, W2.